Yes. Okay. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Blow Up Couch Show. This is Bean, and I'm Julia. Today, we're interviewing Bean's human, Grace, a musician, a host, and I gosh darn love her so much. Let's get ready to rumble! Welcome to your house.
It's good to be here.
So you are a musician, mm-hmm. We've established.
Yeah.
It's like very weird as a creative person to even try to be like, this is what I am.
Well, I think also with anything creative, it's subjective. So like someone could, I'd be like, I'm a musician. And someone could be like, no, you're not. You suck. So it's like kind of a hard thing to enter into a room and be like, I do this thing, and people could be like, badly, and it's like, all right, well.
What did you want to be when you grew up, like when you were a kid?
For a long time, I wanted to be a comedian, mm-hmm. and I really was drawn in by people like Gilda Radner and like Tina Fey, and SNL was like, that's the goal. I wanted to be at 30 Rock. Mm-hmm. Humor was like my coping mechanism, mm-hmm. and when I actually became more comfortable with myself, I found that that wasn't really my desired mode of expression. I found for me, it was just sort of like discounting my own self-worth. Like I would open up every stand-up performance, like making a joke about being a lesbian. And yeah. I was like, I don't need to, I don't feel like I really want to be doing that anymore.
Right.
I'd rather just write really sad songs about being a lesbian.
Yes. Like, how do you stay creative? Because sometimes I feel like it can be a lot of pressure to be like, I have to constantly like keep making things that are good and I like them. Like, what do you do when you get writer's block?
I have no idea how it works at all. But I do know that what does help me is getting out of the house.
Yeah.
Spending some time with my dog, Willie. Almost every song I've written that I like has started on a walk with him. Not bring your phone with you, and mm-hmm. you have to get yourself to a place, at least for me, where I can feel something. Because mm-hmm. a lot of my songs are written either from the perspective of like a character or written about me like tapping into something that I wasn't mature enough to deal with.
Right.
And then I can deal with it. But only when I find those moments of like stillness and quiet. I think the other thing too with regards to songwriting is... And that's why I walk with Willie and not Bean.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, we forgot the Capri Sun! I should have asked, Grace.
Yeah.
Would you like to indulge in some...
Yeah, for sure.
All right. Yeah. You're really holding it in your mouth.
Man, that's a lot of flavor.
I don't know what to call these. Segment feels too rigid. Bit feels too... loose goose. So I think I'm going with game question mark. So our first challenge.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Welcome. We have transformed. I am now a music journalist.
I got that.
I'm a renowned music critic, and we're here today with Grace SEMLER to do a track by track and to look at some of her hit tracks and see why you wrote them. Okay. First, I want to talk about a classic number. The song you wrote called I'll Eat All the Sand on This Beach, I Swear to God. Could you sort of tell me why you were inspired to write that and what it's about?
Yeah, honestly, I was so hungry. Mm-hmm. I was at Will Rogers mm-hmm. State Beach.
Mm-hmm. We know it, we love it.
I didn't bring a picnic, and the people that I was with did, and they wouldn't let me eat any of their picnic.
No.
And and I was just, I felt like a song coming on. I was like, mm-hmm. I'm so mad.
Yeah.
And I remember looking at my friend, Aaron, mm-hmm. and I was like, I'll eat all the sand on this beach, I swear to God.
So track number two, Just a Couple of Popes. What inspired that?
Popes?
Just a Couple of Popes.
Popes.
You?
Well, this was actually like, this was a bit more of a commentary on sort of the stance of the Catholic Church on gay marriage.
Oh.
And I wanted to sort of like turn the mirror a little bit on them and be like, well, you know, what about if it was just a couple of popes?
Yeah.
Like, what if the couple was popes?
So those were upbeat.
Yeah, those were dance anthems.
Again, we veer back into dance with with don't tell me, parenthetical, not to stare directly into the sun. So, you know, people probably will know this by don't tell me
not to stare directly into the sun.
But I'm gonna do it, cause it's fun.
Don't tell me not to stare directly in the sun.
Don't tell me. With your last track, a really somber number, how did this moth get in here?
Wow, I wasn't expecting you to bring that one up.
I know, it's the hidden track. You have to wait 5 minutes of silence.
Right.
And then in plays, how did this moth get in here? And
oh, it's striking. Whoa. And it should be, because actually it was inspired by the Mothman prophecies. I didn't want to say his full name in a song.
Right.
I didn't want to give him that platform, but I did, you know, well, how did this moth get in here? And by here, I mean in my brain. Like,
yes.
How did this moth get in my brain?
And get out. Well, it was a joy to listen to this beautiful song. So.
Same.
Thank you for enlightening us.
It was a joy to write them
to
all.
My hat to you. And I leave it tipped. That's how much I liked it. It's time for a very exciting game, a staple of this couch show, called Real or Fake.
Okay.
Dun 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 dun. You've spent some time in the crime world.
Well, I'm so sorry. I have an interest in true crime, but I actually have not committed, you know, maybe crimes of fashion, but.
So I'm going to read you some CSI terminology. And you're going to tell me whether you think it's a real word or a fake word that I made up.
Okay.
CSI edition. Real or fake? Alger mortis.
Fake.
Real.
No way.
It's the cooling of the body that follows death.
How is it spelled?
A-L-G-O-R mortis.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Real or fake? Intraduncoxis.
Fake.
Correct. It's a fake word.
What
did you
write? It
could be when you dunk on someone so hard they collapse on themselves.
Oh yeah. Well, I'm a big fan of the NBA, so I've seen that happen.
Yes. Real or fake? Hematoma.
Real.
It is real. It's internal bleeding.
Yeah.
Really good stuff.
Mm.
Real or fake? Duodenum.
That's real.
Do you know what it is?
Yeah, it's like something near your butt, right?
Yes. It's
like
part of the small intestine.
Yeah.
Which could be near your butt. I don't have a good working knowledge of the human body.
Yeah, me neither, but I know I've seen that on a chart before.
Real or fake? Cardinarficers.
That's fake. That's very fake.
It's really fake. I didn't practice that one. Okay, real or fake? Dancreas.
That is fake.
That's fake!
Yeah, I really am just going off of your expressions.
I need to get better at this! Okay. Can't read my face. Infarction.
It's fake.
No, it's real.
Hey, come on, say it again.
Infarction.
Infarction? Spell it.
I-N-F-A-R-C-T-I-O-N. Infarction.
Infarction?
Infarction.
What does it mean?
Tissue death within an organ.
Infarction. It's gonna be fake.
No? Reshuffle. Real or fake? Burr hole surgery.
Burr hole. Spell burr.
B-U-R-R.
I think it's fake for the following reason, that you guys were just writing butthole surgery and you wanted to like not do that, so you just substituted in two R's.
You would think that, wouldn't you? But you're wrong! Because it's the drilling a hole in a skull. It's the drilling of a hole in a skull.
It's called burr hole surgery?
I don't think
that's the term for it. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. But like, you imagine like, oh, we need to drill a hole in the skull. Let's do some burr hole surgery. I gotta do some bee hole surgery.
There's so many bee holes on the body.
Are there?
Well,
there's pretty much
belly
one.
Belly button hole. Again, I wasn't keeping track, but I think you did. I think you won.
I think I did fine.
It felt like you won.
Yeah, I mean, there were some minor infarctions, but aside from that, I think I did okay.
And that's gotta be what that word actually means. We're deflating the couch with our body weights, and Grace, gosh oh gosh.
Thanks for having me on.
Thanks for letting us into your home, letting
Anytime.
Us bond with Bean.
Yes.
And asking you all these gosh darn questions.
Yeah, I'm so excited to have been included.
Thank you all for watching, and goodbye.
killer the whole time. It's me. Who left a ransom note for Jean-Benet Ramsey? Me. Bean.